While CapCut started out as a beginner editor, some of the latest app updates have moved it more into professional territory. And as someone who's been editing videos for 20 years, I now find myself using CapCut for 99% of my video editing projects. So in this video, I want to share 5 new features that experienced editors will love that CapCut have added to their desktop software recently. Now, I'll start by saying that you need to update your CapCut from the CapCut website to get the very latest version of the software, since it won't always automatically prompt you to update to the very latest. So start by going ahead and doing that. The first feature that will make editing easier has to do with track height. So here I am inside one of my video edits. As you can see, I've already put most of the edit together. But one thing that has always been an issue with CapCut is having tracks that are really small. And this makes it hard to see what video that track is without having to look up here in the viewer. For example, if you want to pull one of these clips over to the left-hand side, you don't know what it is. Well, over on the left-hand side, if you click track settings and now track height, they've recently added the option to make the track height tall. And look at that, we can instantly see what is ahead on our timeline. It's very big and easy to pick up. Now, if you're an experienced editor, you probably edit by looking at the waveforms on the timeline and using that to see where the pauses are, where the new takes start, and so on. And the visual of the waveform becomes crucially important to speedy cutting of dialogue-based clips. Well, CapCut has also added another feature. If you click the same track settings button and now down to audio waveform size, if you change that to 100, suddenly the video track gets replaced by those audio waveforms. So now I can see exactly where the gaps are if I wanted to cut out silences. I don't need to squint and look at these tiny little things that they had before. So having big audio waveforms is invaluable to easily seeing where the pauses are, whether you're editing a video with the audio built in or a separate audio track that you've synced up. And the faster your eye can see and process things like these two track sizes, the faster you'll be able to edit. With longer edits, it can take a really long time if you're having to stop at every single cut and squint and try and figure out exactly where the pause ends and the next line begins. So it's little workflow shortcuts like this that will save you hours on bigger projects. The next feature is a frustration that many of us have had with CapCut, and that is not having the ability to do ripple editing, where if you use keyboard shortcuts like Q and W, like here, or press Q to ripple delete left, you'll see that it only deleted the video but not the audio. And this made it a really long and arduous process to ripple edit a video if you want to cut both the audio track and the video track simultaneously. So here I've got my video track, and underneath is my audio track that I recorded separately. I'm going to right click these two and choose sync video to audio. I'll turn the volume down on the video track, and now I'm going to create a compound clip. Now with this compound clip, ripple editing is so much easier due to the bigger track heights as well as the larger audio waveforms, making it easy to cut both the video and audio simultaneously. Now, while we could already do this before, the fact that we can get much higher track heights and much bigger audio waveforms means that this workflow is now possible, because before, again, you had to squint to see what you were doing, and this made this workflow of combining everything into one compound clip impossible. And now that ripple editing is much easier due to being much more visual, it means cutting talking head videos becomes much easier, and therefore your editing time will speed up substantially. Using the Q and W keyboard shortcuts will save you so much time in any video edit, and mean you can spend your time instead on the more important creative decisions. If you want to know which other keyboard shortcuts I use inside CapCut to edit 10 times faster, I wrote a free guide, which you can download below, that will show you exactly what the best keyboard shortcuts are for CapCut and how to install them into your CapCut. The next new feature advanced editors will love is paste attributes. You know how sometimes when you're editing a talking head and you want to zoom in and out throughout the clip, and you might do this, say, 10, 20 times throughout your entire video, but it's not always easy to line up the sweet spot from shot to shot in the exact position you want it. Say you want the eye line perfectly in line with a certain point, and then when you cut from shot to shot, you don't want the eyeline to change. Well, previously doing this in CapCut was nearly impossible to do, where you would have to zoom in a certain amount and reposition. Then for the next shot, you'd have to do the same thing and try your best to make it match, but it shows up slightly differently and it takes forever to make the two shots look identical. This is where copy and paste attributes saves the day. So let's say I like the zoom and position of this clip here. What I'm going to do is right click it, and then up here, I'm going to click copy attributes. Now with our second clip, I'm going to right click it and then paste attributes. Now you can choose exactly what it pastes. This includes video factors, audio factors, and color correction. So you can either copy paste them all or just specific aspects. So here I just want to copy paste the video size and position. So I'll click paste and voila, we have the same level of zoom with the exact same framing from clip to clip. The fifth feature experienced editors will love has to do with keyframing. So previously, if you want to keyframe a clip, here I have a silly reaction of me for a short I'm making. And what I want to do is make an overdramatic zoom into my face. So normally what you do is create a keyframe at the start, then move the timeline along, then increase the scale and position, and this will automatically create another keyframe. And here's what it looks like. So that wasn't bad, but it was very robotic. It's like a zoom and then it stops suddenly. But now what we can do to smooth this zoom out is right click the clip and select show keyframe animation. You'll want to zoom your timeline so it's nice and visible. What we're going to do is start by clicking the first keyframe under scale and smooth it out by clicking this button here, which will add an auto curve. As you can see, this line is now curved, representing a smoother transition. If you're repositioning your clip like I did by moving it down, you'll want to do this for the X and Y coordinates as well. So I'm going to click them twice to expand them, click the keyframe, add the auto curve, as well as with the Y coordinate auto curve. Now let's watch this back. And we've just created a smooth, stylish zoom in without that noticeable stopping point. Now you can customize these curves further if you want specialized paths for any of your coordinates, or if you wanted to add multiple keyframes along your timeline. Let's say you want to zoom out again and reposition it. You just repeat the process by smoothing out the curve. And there we have it. Smooth, stylish keyframe animations. So if you do find yourself using keyframes a lot, this is a good way to make your animations feel a bit more natural and give the movements more character. Now I want to throw one more feature in there that is a feature I use for this very video, and that has to do with multicam editing. So as you'll have seen throughout the video, I cut back and forth between myself and my computer screen. So here on my timeline, I've got me at the top and the computer screen on the bottom. And instead of manually cutting out sections to reveal the B-roll underneath it, which can be a really long process when you're editing longer videos, the much faster workflow I followed was selecting both clips, right-clicking, and choosing Create Multi-Camera Clip. Here it automatically syncs them together, and I'd recommend turning proxy on just to speed it up a little bit, but once you press create, it combines both videos into one, where all you need to do throughout the edit is click on the screen you want to show, whether it's you or your computer. So let's do it for this clip here. As you can see, it's currently showing my screen, but if I just click on myself, there we go, there I am. Then for the clip after that, you can choose which perspective you want to show, whether it's you or the screen recording, or if you're working with multiple cameras, you could also select those as well, as long as there's a clear waveform that can sync them up. So this is how I edited this video, by going through it line by line, making cuts, choosing the perspective I want, then moving to the next cut point and repeating the process. So following this multi-camera editing workflow is going to be much faster than cutting up different layers on the timeline when you're working with multiple different camera angles and, in my case, screen recordings. So that's it. I hope you enjoyed the video. While I do love CapCut for all the catchy templates and effects, what really matters in the grand scheme of things as a video editor is workflow speed. The more you can do to speed that time up so you're able to edit videos in a lot less time, that's what really makes a difference in the long run and mean you can turn over so much more work. If you are still somewhat new to CapCut and you want to learn the entire program in less than a day, feel free to check out my CapCut masterclass where I guide you through every single feature of CapCut and get you up and running quickly with editing your very first professional video project in it. I will say also that CapCut have been very good with introducing AI features. Some of them are totally mind-blowing. In this video here, I'll share some of the very best ones that will give your videos an instant wow factor.